major shakeup at Uber. The founder, Travis Kalanick, stepping down as the company's CEO.
Tracy Carrasco, who's been following this story closely for us, has more details. What is going on? Good morning, Trace.
Good morning, ladies. Now, this is a real U-turn from last week's announcement that Travis Kalanick would take a leave of absence. Kalanick's exit yesterday came under pressure after lots of drama involving Uber's investors who felt time off wasn't enough. After putting millions of dollars into the company and seeing its valuation swell to nearly $70 billion, these shareholders said Kalanick had to go. Leading that charge, one of Uber's biggest shareholders, venture capital firm Benchmark, which has one of its partners, Bill Gurley, on Uber's board. The investors made their demand for Kalanick to step down in a letter delivered to him while he was in Chicago. In a statement given to the New York Times, Kalanick said, "I love Uber more than anything in the world, and at this difficult moment in my personal life, I have accepted the investors' request to step aside so that Uber can go back to building rather than be distracted with another fight." Uber's board responded with a statement, "Travis has always put Uber first. This is a bold decision and a sign of his devotion and love for Uber. By stepping away, he's taking the time to heal from his personal tragedy while giving the company room to fully embrace this new chapter in Uber's history. We look forward to continuing to have him serve on the board." Now, Kalanick's troubles began earlier this year after a former Uber engineer detailed what she said was sexual harassment at the company, leading to more complaints and internal investigations. Uber recently fired more than 20 employees after an investigation into the company's culture and vowed to make major changes in the workplace, starting with management at the top. Now, those personal tragedy, his mother passed away in a boating accident earlier in May.
That is true. But now you have a company that will be operating without a CEO, a CFO, and a COO. So what's next for this leadership team?
You know, they've been operating with, I think it's a 14-member committee. The board is looking for a new CEO, as you said, a CFO. So they've really got to do some searching right now.
But he's still got that stake in the company.
He does.
That's
the big thing. He really does. He'll still be around.
Yeah. Tracy, thank you very much.